Basically, till now, till now we were talking about bamboo as a structural material, bamboo as a handicap material, etc. Now, I'll speak a little bit about bamboo as a building material for our system, our health. And first and foremost thing is, bamboo harvesting is really so difficult as it has been for me to arrange my lecture here, because it grows in deep forest and from there it takes longer time and labor also. So first, first origin of bamboo. The studies indicate that woody bamboos have evolved in lowland tropics of Gondwana land during the tertiary period, and bamboo dispersed to Asia from India after land connection was established between India and Eurasian plates. When Gondwana plate came and the Tethys ocean was there, so an Eurasian plate came together and then bamboo came also along with the Gondwana land. So this is the origin of bamboo which we consider now, this Srivastava and Clark. So bamboo, it is named variously, wa in Manipuri, bamboo in English, bas in Hindi. This word also has its two speculations of origin. One is from India only, and second is from Malaysia, when bamboo was put in fire and then it used to make a sound to scare away the animals, bum boom. So people say like this, it has the origin of bamboo from there. For first one speculation, bamboo to bamboo, I have this writer from the literature. The earliest mention of world from which the present world has come is bamboo. It was there in Goa, where Portugalese came in India. And there's a book written by this Arabian, Avisnan. There he mentioned first time tabakshir, which tabakshir is a liquid coming from a plant which was at that time called bamboo. And then this and Garcia de Ota described many plants from India in this, in his book Colloquios de Simples Drogas of Da India in 1563, who was Portuguese, and also mentioned about tabakshir. According to Garcia da Ota, the local people around the Goa at that time called medicine sakar mambu. Sakar is sweet in Portugal, and mambu is Goa word, Goan word, it is Indian, that reed, that grass. Then came to another person, Gaspar Bauhin, or Caspar Bauhin, this Swiss botanist, used the word arundo for reed grass of India in his book. And Bauhin mentioned that the substance derived from arunda was called tabakshir, coming from that 11th century by this Avicennans and Arabs, and that the plant producing tabakshir was called mambu by Indians. This mambu became Bambusa, the basis of genus Bambusa of Linnaeus, and bamboo in English. So this is the origin of the word again from the Indian subcontinent. In India, our literature indicating bamboo use goes to Rig Veda very long ago. Lord Indra was advised to propagate bamboo for his armory. Then this bamboo music our Lord Krishna used to play again 3-4,000 years ago. So this is the use at that time. This is game from this place originated, this game, polo game, Sago Kangzei. Here also the ball and the stick and that long attachment with the stick of playing Kangzei is made of bamboo. And its origin is also indicated that it is 3000 BC or more. So at that time also bamboo was used here for playing, for music, for other purpose also, 3 to 4,000 years or 5,000 years back. So this is the story about that, that polo ground or polo game origin in India. And here bamboo is in every aspect in our country, right from deity. So this photograph is from Tripura. Their bamboo is considered as a deity. A god is made from the bamboo, green bamboo, and we have a festival around this. And this you will see around here in courtyard of temples or houses, this bamboo signals for auspicious thing. And in Manipur, it is considered that a house without bamboo is unlucky. So every courtyard should have the bamboo grow in the houses. But I will not speaking on this much. My interest is on bamboo as a food. Bamboo as a food in animals to men, how it has come. These two gentlemen were basically, these are carnivores animals, these giant panda, and they are now exclusive bamboo eater. This red panda, again carnivores, but he has become lazy, I can say, don't go for hunting, and started eating only bamboo. And this bamboo lambur from Madagascar, there are 5 to 6 species of bamboo lambur in Madagascar. They exclusively eat bamboo, different species or different parts. And now they have become endangered because people are cutting bamboo and they cannot eat anything else but bamboo. And they have delicacy bamboo. And animals or our curiosity have taught bamboo eating. I will tell few stories related to this. One story from Mizoram. This is bamboo dance. Yesterday you saw this bamboo dance is famous in Mizoram, Chirao dance. And in bamboo there is a story how they started eating bamboo shoots. Long, long ago there was a tortoise, and he used to come out, eat bamboo shoot for 3 months, and then go for sleeping hibernation. These people kept on seeing. They thought this gentleman comes, eats just for 3 months, and then sleeps rest of the year. What a nice thing. And they started eating bamboo. This is a story, still they are in folklore. This again, this bamboo technology established because of some accident in our Meghalaya. There are 2 tribes, Nongsis and Zerwa. So they don't eat bamboo shoots. Why? Because their forefathers eaten bamboo shoots somewhere and during hunting, and they died. Because of that, they are not eating now. The story is very interesting. During that time, people used to go for hunting, and if they could not find anything to eat, the bamboo shoots were growing, so they started eating, and all died because bamboo shoots release cyanogen. Cyanogenic glycoside is a compound which reacts with cyanogenic glycosidase and releases cyanide, and that cyanide, you all know, is dangerous, and that high content will be fatality. So from here now, they don't eat bamboo shoots till today because their forefathers were died because of this. In our literature, it is clearly mentioned that bamboo by nature is fixative and frigid, seminal, curative, palatable, bladder purifier, and full of astringent juice. It is splits scurf, subsides bile, cures leprosy, bloody flux, wounds, and so on. So in Ayurveda, etc., it is mentioned that bamboo shoots are medicinally and health-wise very important, very good for this. This Chyawanprash, this is a tonic. I think it has come around 5 to 6 thousand years back, you know, and it is still very famous and tonic in today's time. Patanjali people are making this tonic. This is again having a very interesting story how this tonic started. At that time, there was a king, and he came in the forest along with his daughter, and daughter went here and there and started looking something. There was something in the termites, and lights were coming from there, and she pierced the 2 sticks, and when piercing 2 sticks, a person got up and shouted, "What?" and cried. So she scared, and he became very angry. He said, "I'll curse you." The king came, he said, "Please don't do that, and I'll get you married with my daughter." And that with that old man, she was married, young lady around 16 to 20 years, and she was staying there. One day, celestial Ashwini brothers, we called celestial doctors at that time, came around there, and they saw the young lady there. See, they asked, "What are you doing here?" come along with us. She said, no, I have a husband here, I am with him. And they saw the husband is very old, sitting on this hermitage. So they said, okay, you leave him. She said, no, I cannot do that. Only thing is you make him very energetic and active. They said, okay. Then they put a condition. If you recognize your husband, then we will do whatever we can for that. So they made a pond full of, in today's term we call spa. So herbs, etc. And all three went inside, two brothers and that old saint, and came out. But she recognized her husband clearly. And then they said, okay, you are very pure and sanctified. So we will make a tonic for your husband. And this tonic they made, Chyawanpras, it has all herbs, are more than 40. And one of ingredient here is this bas lochan or tabakshir, which Arab people named in 11th century, or bamboo mana. So at that time also it was added. Around 5000 years back, bas lochan was added. Its content is 150 gram in that. So since then, this tonic is coming, and still people are using this bas lochan for making this tonic. And there are other herbs also. In Assam, how to get the nutrients from bamboo? They have a very unique technique. This is also, again, old tradition, and it's still going on. On National Highway, when one day I was moving, so I saw these hanging ones. These things. Sorry. And I saw inside, it's a curd. And this curd is 4 times costlier than the normal curd. They make it inside these bamboo cones. And bamboo extracts the nutrients, this curd extracts the nutrients from the wall of the inner wall of the bamboo. And they eat it. This is Korean method of extracting the nutrients from the bamboo. What they do? They put wine in these bamboo cones and season for 6 months, 7 months, it's up to them. And after that they take it. The cost is 3 times of this wine. And Chinese people are more intelligent. What they did? They put this wine in the growing bamboo. And then after 1 year or 2 years, they extract this wine from this bamboo cone and sell it 3-4 times. And it has nutrients mixed with this wine coming outside. And Korean, again, the leaves, we think that leaves are waste. No, it has all antioxidants. And they are just green leaves are boiling and drinking daytime or continuously. And it's providing you antioxidants, which are very important now in our health. So these are the benefits of this tea. It is available now in Korea and China, etc., many countries. And in the USA also now it is very famous. This gentleman, as I told you, panda eats only bamboo and cannot, because its alimentary canal is of carnivorous animal, cannot digest the herbs or plants. So 70% to 80% comes out just like that. So one gentleman from China, what he did? See the cost of the tea. What he did? He collected this all manure from the panda and put in the tea garden and growing the tea in the dung of panda. So it has become bamboo panda tea. Now I'll come directly to with the suits in which we are working. And in suits, we are now in this area or northeast, we are now eat a lot of bamboo shoots. But whenever I go to the people, I ask why you are eating. They say, I'm eating because I have to eat. What is the benefits? We don't know. And even we educated people don't know definitely what are the benefits of these suits, why we are eating since centuries. So now we are scientifically trying to find out what are inside these and in what way these are benefiting to us. The way bamboo shoots are sold in our market, fresh shoots, dried and fermented. And this technique, this is unique technique. I can say it is unique and best technique for preserving bamboo shoots for more than 1 year or 2 years. And as it becomes older, it is costlier. What they do, here the bamboo shoots of this place have high content of cyanogenic leukocytes. And they just chop bamboo shoots in small pieces and put in the water in these containers and just forget. And this cyanogenic leukocytes keep on coming in the water and it's dissolved, gone away, and the source become health food and sold in the market. And we and these are available. Bamboo shoots season is for 3 months. These are available for 1 year, 2 year, like that. So very costly. In Manipur, you will find here these type of heaps of bamboo shoots. This is again fermentation of different technique. That was unique. Another one. This is they ferment it and then sell it in the open market like this. I don't think any food item, vegetables especially, you will find this and see months together open like this and no spoilage. And here interesting thing is there is a small heap and bigger heap. A small heap is costlier because it is fermented for more than 1 year, and the bigger heap is fermented for less than 1 year. It is continuous process of fermentation. This is another technique of storing bamboo shoots for more than 1 year in Assam. They chop bamboo shoots in small pieces, mix with the spices, etc., make these type of big heaps in a container and take out little bit and keep on eating like this. So these are the different techniques of bamboo shoot processing in our area, in this area. And we have around 145 to 50 tribes, different communities or tribes we call, and their own unique technique of processing bamboo shoots their way. And it's really very different from each other. Though we are staying very close to each other, but we follow different methods of eating bamboo shoots here. Internationally, these are the countries. In China, it is called treasure dish, or there is no banquet without bamboo shoots. They are also eating since centuries. In Japan, it is called king of forest vegetables. In Korea also, Indonesia, Thailand, Taiwan, or South, these oriental countries, they eat bamboo shoots. Some countries eat more or some like this, little bit, but they eat. And these are the species preferred by different countries for bamboo shoots. And these are the modern techniques of processing or packaging bamboo shoots. And now we are promoting this yellow one, paste. This paste system is very good for adding in the different food items, and this our lab is process promoting it. These are traditional bamboo shoots from this place, Kangsui and Uti. You have, please taste it. It's available in the market. And these are different food items from Northeast India. Again, different types making different food items from our bamboo shoots. And these are the contemporary or our lab materials which we are using, how to fortify food items with the bamboo shoots. And so, as I told you, I'm using, or our lab is using, this bamboo shoots in the form of paste or powder. And these are chapatis, puris, pakoda, dahi, etc., kachap, our students are making. And we are analyzing how much nutrients are coming to the food and from food to us, and what benefits we are getting. So these type of link is being done in our laboratory. And these are modern, again, nutraceuticals in the form of tablets, etc. You can eat, the people are eating bamboo shoots, or salt also. In Korea, bamboo salt is very famous. Now, nutritive things. Yeah, it is rich in protein, amino acids, carbohydrates, phytosterol, phenols, dietary fiber, and lot of minerals. These are the bamboo shoots from Northeast and Himalayan region. We are taking bamboo shoots one by one and analyzing what are inside these. So these are the different bamboo species and their shoots, and have showing the macronutrients. Bamboo shoots, we have seen, it is having almost all amino acids, essential or non-essential, etc. All amino acids are present in our these bamboo shoots. These minerals, it is very rich in minerals, especially like silica, potassium, phosphorus. Fiber. Yes, bamboo shoot is nothing. Bamboo is nothing but fiber. And again, bamboo shoots are having fiber. And this is the list of bamboo species which we are analyzing our laboratory. And this vitamin C, many vitamins, just C, vitamin C and E, we have shown here in different species, phenols. Yeah, a little bit I will take you like a few minerals, except in detail, like fiber. What benefits we are getting from these things? It is bamboo shoot is low in calories. It is very important. I will come to it later. Low in fats and cholesterol, high in phytosterols, high in many vitamins like C and E, rich in phenols and other biotic compounds, high in amino acids, I have told you. And I will discuss about potassium and silica, which is rich in here, and dietary fiber. First is calories. We are sitting, so we need less calorie, but we are eating high calorie food, and especially the empty calories. Empty calories, you may be knowing, like solid fats, butter, it is empty calorie. We are eating 100% calorie, but nothing is there as in the form of food like fiber. Like sugar, it is empty calories. So we should avoid calories, empty calories, and eat food items so that we get little calories and more for our belly's work. It should be continuously busy. And see the amount of fiber. Bamboo shoots, 27 calories. And wheat, etc., rice, they have high calories. And if we don't do physical work, then where this calorie will go? So if you have less physical work, eat bamboo shoots, so you will get less, and you will become healthy like panda or red panda as it is there. Health benefits of potassium. Potassium is very important element. I will read it. Daily requirement of potassium for an adult is around 4,700 milligram. Potassium is important cation in intercellular fluid and particles in acid and base balance. Regulates osmotic pressure. Conducts nerve impulse, pulse contraction and cell membrane function. Controls blood pressure high and low. And high intake of potassium will reduce sodium level. The sodium level should not be more in our system. It should be 1:1. Yeah. And high intake of potassium may decrease the risk of stroke and coronary artery disease. It has been observed that 1,040 milligram of everyday potassium, there's a reduction of 21% of risk of strokes. Very important. High dietary intake of potassium is related with bone mineral density and bone mass. High intake of potassium reduces calcium release in urine. If you have more calcium, then calcium release will be less. High urinary calcium increases the risk of developing kidney stones. Daily intake of potassium around 4,700 milligram reduces kidney stones. And see the potassium amount in bamboo shoots, 4,231 to 6,660, and another compare with other food items. Silica is very important. Before 1972, we used to consider the silica is not important for our body. But after 1970, people have started now. Silica is in our nails, our bones, our hairs, and our skin is stressed. It is because of silica. Silica is good for our longevity, lifelong. And see that in Western countries, people think that horse tail is the maximum having the silica, and that's why horse tail is sold there for silica addition in food. But see the comparison bamboo shoots. It is very high in bamboo shoots. And where silica is there inside that this bamboo shoots, you see this white powder. This white powder is amorphous powder rich in silica and other minerals. You see this SI 550 milligram in 10 gram. And this bamboo curd, as I showed in Assam, people are doing. This is because of extracting these minerals. And there are other minerals also in this white amorphous substance. Dietary fiber, all you know the benefits of dietary fiber. Earlier also we were not giving importance to it. But after 1953, we have started giving. And this dietary fiber is creating a lot of problem in developed countries because they are taking processed food like bread, etc. That in wheat, we are leaving behind the fiber. And I will show the table. See, we are having in our diet 39 to 43 gram dietary fiber, Indians, whereas these developed countries are having very less. And because of this, there are a lot of problems. And daily uptake should be 25 gram per day. Dietary fiber in different items comparison with the bamboo shoots. These are the problems associated with the, if you are not having dietary fiber in your diet, especially up to cancer level also. And this is, we have a recommendation, daily, they recommended daily allowance, and in bamboo shoots, this much percentage is available, all these items in our food. Unfortunately, in our this part, we are having this problem of bamboo famine, and we are scared of it, especially Mizoram, this when bamboo flowering comes, we are scared of its omen, bad omen. And it is now, it is recorded since 1739. It is nothing but it is flowering or fruiting of the bamboo shoots in a particular period and profuse fruiting. But we are not using these fruits. These fruits are very nutritive and aphrodisiac. And the rats multiply, eat and multiply and multiply, and then this becomes a problem. And we are not using it, and become it for us, it is a problem, disaster. We have to use it. Conclusions. Bamboo shoots have great potential for becoming big industry in northeastern region of India. Bamboo shoots consumed in fresh, dried and fermented. There are a number of locally developed fermentation and other processing technologies for bamboo shoots in the region. There are places like Andhra, Bishnupur, Quetta in this region, which are famous for bamboo shoot processing. Fermentation is the best method for processing bamboo shoots for increasing shelf life, easy transportation and handling, as well as increasing the nutritional values. Bamboo shoots are low in calories, fats, cholesterol and high in dietary fibers, minerals, phytosterols and various biotic compounds like phenols. Consumption of shoots will give health benefits, food security and better management of bamboo plantation, and particularly for sympodial types. If you harvest bamboo shoots, especially in sympodial one, then there will be less clumping and thickening will be less. In past, bamboo was considered the best food and medicine in oriental countries. Now in 21st century, it has come in a new avatar as health food and much more for entire world. These are our funding agencies: Ministry of Food Processing, Government of India, Department of Biotechnology, American Bamboo Society, Nat Jayaquid. My collaborators, Professor Kanan Bala from Manipur University, Professor C. Nirmala, Department of Botany, Punjab University. And this is their group. I am very grateful to these students, our students, whose data I have used here. And this is my group at Shillong. And eat bamboo shoots, be healthy. Thank you very much.